Welcome back to The Breakfast on Plus TV Africa. We head straight to our third conversation in no time. We'll be out of here. But the conversation about who deserves the Ballon d'Or is ongoing. Should it be Messi, Robert Lewandowski, Mbappe, amongst others? We do have Moses Ikpo who joins us this morning to share his thoughts on the issue. Good morning, Moses, and thank you for joining us.
Good morning. It's a pleasure from here.
All right, so quickly, let's head straight to the crux of the matter. Who do you think deserves the Ballon d'Or? Messi, does he really deserve it?
One thing we must realize is that football has gone beyond what the fans think personally, and football has gone scientific. There is a lot of technical input, voting process that FIFA undertakes to avoid such doubt. Though to the fans, it might not just be what they want. But let's look at it from the literal aspect of it. The COVID situation last year, for me, I felt affected a little bit of the decision making. And knowing that Messi had always been there on top as one of the kings between him and Ronaldo, I think it should have been a tough decision for the technical committee and those voting coaches and the captains around the world that voted for the Ballon d'Or technical committee. So they voted against Lewandowski, Mbappe, and in favor of Messi. Messi's quality is not in doubt. His antecedent is not in doubt. He's a good player. He's a king in his own making. Lewandowski, by some fans, feel that actually he deserves to have been the closest rival at this period. But all the same, there are people, experts, that have looked into a lot of factors considering performance. And I think Lewandowski was affected by the COVID of last season. And that is why Messi just took it from him as a king.
Yeah, but you know, the argument that fans have actually put out, it's really what we can see, talking about the number of goals scored, you know, in the season. And it feels, not feels, but it is, if you look at it, that Robert Lewandowski seemed to have the highest goals scored and even the assists. When you juxtapose it with that of Messi and also looking at Mbappe, Ronaldo as well.
Now, if you look at Mbappe, you look at Lewandowski, you look at the goals, assists, you look at the stats. The Ballon d'Or is not about the highest goal scorer. It's not about the one with the most number of assists. There is a lot of things that are being considered, which includes the play in the team, how you contribute to your team's success, and the value of the player during the game, what is his influence. A lot of factor. Yeah, you would have given it to Lewandowski by saying that, yeah, he scored more goals if we are trying to look at the king in terms of goal scoring or number of assists. But you look at the contribution so far. And if you look at the contribution so far to the teams and the assistance of the players, and you would have even given it to Ronaldo, because I come here, I'm a very passionate fan of Ronaldo, and that's why I have always try to avoid this conversation, because I always feel biased, sort of, because we look at most of us that are into the game as coaches, we believe that Ronaldo is a product of coaches hard working, and see, Ronaldo is made from God, a natural gifted, Messi is from God, a gifted player. But if you say, let's judge by the highest goal scorer, which of course Lewandowski should have gotten the Ballon d'Or, but it doesn't just stop there. It goes beyond just scoring goals. It also looked at the areas of contributing to your teams and the performance so far. And of course, you know that most people and most of the technical committee that voted in this process would have, of course, looked at Messi as one of the best players in the world, and would have seen it as an insult not to have given him that Ballon d'Or.
All right, Ronaldo himself has actually come out on social media questioning, you know, Messi's, you know, deservance of this particular award. Even Messi himself had did say that he feels Lewandowski was robbed of this particular Ballon d'Or. Does all of that count?
Yeah, but unfortunately for both him and Ronaldo, they were not part of the process of selection and voting. And there is a prerogative power given to those making the vote and their decision making to take their decision and cast their vote on who is the better player to be given the Ballon d'Or. Yes, as players, as fans, we all feel Lewandowski is closer to winning the Ballon d'Or. But we should know that in football, your antecedent at times plays 45% of whatever award will be given to you. And give it up to Messi, give it up to Ronaldo. These are the kings in terms of football in the world. And I feel the voting process was sort of affected by the profile of these players. Personally, I feel it was affected by the profile of the player, personality of the players. And you see, even ordinary in a workplace, the personality of a person at times can speak to him, can speak for him before people that might judge his situation at any point in time. So Messi, Ronaldo are still best. I felt if FIFA really wanted to give us another set of players in terms of development, they should have left Ronaldo and Messi out of the Ballon d'Or award. If that had happened, Lewandowski would have picked up that award easily.
Okay. Some other persons have also argued that probably because, you know, he won some other awards and that would be the reason why he actually, you know, took that one home again. Okay. But apart from that, let's move away from Messi. Apart from Robert Lewandowski, which other person do you think would have been, you know, close to taking that award?
Looking at FIFA trying to tell us if they had said they want to develop players and they want to show the world a new star, I would have looked at the area of Mbappe. He's a player that has a good prospect. He's a player that has contributed a lot to the PSG in his team. He's a young player, he's an upcoming player. He's a player that carries the burden of the team also with the assistance of Neymar and Adrian. So I felt that if Messi was not there, if Ronaldo was not there, and probably Lewandowski is not also there, Mbappe would have been the best option and would have shown the world that this is the new generation of football. This is where football belongs to now. Messi has gotten the award record 7 times at intervals and shared between him and Ronaldo. I strongly, my opinion, when the Ballon d'Or came up, is that the both of them would have allowed, or FIFA would have created, the particular takeover.
All right, thank you, Moses. Thanks for your thought. I'm afraid that's as much as we can take on this particular discourse. We have been speaking with Moses Igbo, football coach, and he has joined us to talk about who deserves the Ballon d'Or. Was it actually Messi after all? Thank you so much, Messi. Or Moses, rather. All right. Messi, why are you in my
Because you were... I'm not. I'm thinking that you're thinking about, you know, Messi himself. Okay, all right, that's the much we can actually take. Thank you so much for being part of the conversation. It has been an amazing ride from Monday up until now. We hope to return Monday next week. In case you missed out on any part of the conversation, that's all right. To follow us on Facebook and Instagram, we're at Plus TV Africa. And on YouTube, is at Plus TV Africa Lifestyle. I am Messi Boko. Do have a great Friday.
And I am Justin Akadenyo. We'll see you again on Monday, but stand by for the news top of the hour.